You can have a hill that's steep enough so you'll roll downhill even with an automatic, so it holds
okay.
up both of them.
And can you tell me a little bit more about how the downhill braking works?
Right. So if you engage the downhill braking, once you reach a certain grade level, then the essentially the ESC system, ABS system, automatically will kick in, and with the engine management system to walk the vehicle down the hill. So if you're on a steep grade, you can just take your foot off the brake and accelerator completely, and the vehicle will hold about 5 miles an hour just all the way down. And then once the grade levels out enough, then it will release and
yeah,
it's back into that.
And manual, four-wheel mm-hmm. drive, two-wheel drive.
Right.
Mario Duenas with Semana News and Solo Autos. On the buyer assurance program, is there a final date for the job loss return vehicle?
So for the assurance program, we just renewed that program for the rest of this year. So at least for the rest of this year, the assurance program still continues on.
So in other words, you might end up at December 31st?
We haven't announced a final date, but we have announced that the program at least is still active through December 31st. That's correct.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Anyone else?
Alvin Jones with the Planet Vehicle. I was taking a look at the turning circle, the radius, the diameter, but I didn't see a comparison with Subaru Forester. Do you have any information on that?
Yes. I think the Forester is almost the same. So I think we're 34.7, and I believe the Forester is 34.4. So almost exactly the same.
Okay, thank you.
Greg Morrison with Bumper to Bumper TV. A lot of states are really pushing the whole issue of distracted drivers, almost mandating hands-free cell phone operation. With that in mind, when is Hyundai going to say, okay, Bluetooth standard across the line, just roll it out the factory that way to avoid the confusion?
Right. Yeah, we have started to do that on some models. So if you look at the new 2011 Sonata, the new 2011 Sonata has Bluetooth hands-free standard. The new Santa Fe has Bluetooth standard as well. In the case of Tucson, just because of the price sensitivity, there is demand for a base model that does not have features like that and cruise control and some of the other features. But even on Tucson, we're expecting that mix to be fairly low. So we're planning that about 85% of Tucson will have a Bluetooth hands-free phone system.
Is the Kia Sportage in that competitive set?
Yes, Sportage would be in the competitive set as well.
Valerie Menard, Decisive Auto Latino. I noticed that you have the backup camera as an option.
Mm-hmm.
What about sensors? Are those standard by any chance, or are those available?
In the case of Tucson,
parking sensors.
Yeah. So we have other vehicles that have parking sensors. In the case of Tucson, we just have the camera with a navigation system. Sensors are definitely a possibility for during the life cycle, but not for launch.
George Polgar, CBS Radio. I know, you know, all these models that you're introducing, obviously you have them equipped differently, but what kind of platform sharing are you doing between, like, this model and other models?
Right. So we have a lot of platform sharing in between, especially, say, the sedans and CUVs. So the Tucson is based on a modified Elantra platform. The next generation Santa Fe will be based on a modified version of the Sonata platform that we just launched. So we are trying to do that kind of platform sharing to to reduce cost on in areas where they're
Santa
hidden.
Fe will be.
Yeah, so the next generation Santa Fe, it'll be based off of the Sonata platform that we just introduced. There are always modifications that go into the platforms to make them optimized for, say, going from a sedan to a CUV. But generally, yeah, they're based on that. You also see that, for example, on Genesis as well. Genesis Coupe, sharing a platform as well.
Any other questions?
In this particular vehicle, how el periódico USA José Luis B. Garza, how works the multi-point injection?
The multi-point injection?
Yeah.
What's the question?
The question is, yes, you have, why is different to other models? Because it's like an innovation in this car, or is a...
Oh, okay, yeah, I understand. Yeah, so multi-point injection is not really an innovation. So, but I wanted to kind of be clear on what our offering is, because on our new 2011 Sonata that we're also kind of launching right now at the same time, that does have... innovative technology, which is the new gasoline direct injection engine. So the new Sonata has the GDI engine. That's very advanced technology, very sophisticated. In the case of Tucson, we decided to stick with more traditional MPI, multi-port injection, in order to reduce the need to put a lot of noise countermeasures in. GDI tends to make the engine noisier, and so you have to put a lot of extra cost into the engine to reduce that noise. And also with Tucson, because Tucson's pretty lightweight, our MPI engine is already pretty powerful as it is. It wasn't necessary to do GDI for Tucson and still get good performance and good fuel economy. So at this time, we decided that using more traditional MPI technology was a better choice to keep Tucson a great value but still have good performance. Moving up to Sonata, which is mid-size class vehicle, it's actually big enough so it's actually classified as a large car inside. In that vehicle, it made more sense to just go ahead and use GDI technology in the new Sonata.
Once again, Alvin Jones, Planet Vehicle. Two questions, ground clearance and luggage capacity.
The ground clearance, I don't remember it off the top of my head, but I do have it with me, and the luggage capacity I have as well. Luggage capacity went up about 3 cubic feet from the old vehicle, so I can get you the exact numbers right after the Q&A.
Once again, Valerie with Decisive Auto Latino. Do you have fuel economy for the manual?
Yes, the manual is 1 mpg less, so it's 2230 for the manual.